Okay, chat. I'm always honest with you, and that includes today. I copied this deck off the internet, and we're gonna try and figure out how it works together. So Paradox Engine's the key card here. Whenever you cast a spell, untap all non-land permanents you control. And we've got four Karn the Great Creator and a Fae of Wishes to find an extra Paradox Engine out of the sideboard. And then we've got a bunch of things that make mana when you tap them, and we have Emery here as well. So I believe the win conditions are as follows. Emery with two Mox Ambers lets you go infinite with Paradox Engine. So Engine, Emery, two Mox Ambers, because Mox is legendary. So you play a Mox, you untap your Emery with the Engine, you make a mana, you use Emery, make another Mox from the board, loop it through again. And then also, you eventually kill with Aetherflux Reservoir. When you cast a spell, you gain one life for each spell you've cast this turn, pay 50 life, deal 50 damage to any target. And then while you're looping Mox in, you can also make tokens with Saheeli. Emery, Kinian, and Sphere draws your deck. Emery, Kinian. Oh, so Sphere with Kinian. Kinian lets Chromatic Sphere make two mana. So you can sack Chromatic Sphere for two mana and then use Emery to replay it plus sack from your bin. And then this lets you draw your entire deck because it's mana neutral. Yeah, this is definitely like Proc-Clon Ironworks adjacent. So let's jump in and see how this goes. I want to pull up my cardboard live page here so we can look at my sideboard. Okay. Deck's confirmed unbeatable. They know what's coming for him, chat. Oh, are they playing Tybalt's Trickery? They just mulliganed like six times. That's probably what happened, right? They're playing Tybalt's Trickery in Historic. Hey, no longer feel bad. Hundred percent win rate, blue-green Paradox Engine. Jeff, what's your record with the deck? Does it feel good? Haven't lost a match, Twitch chat. I know you really care about the record. Literally undefeated. Don't worry about the record with the deck, chat. Your record with the deck is irrelevant. Unless your sample size is like up into the three digits, don't think about records. It's like fine, right? Not amazing, but fine. We've tapped green into blue. I was going to spend the wild cards anyway, so it doesn't really matter how this deck does. Big Hoglandy energy. Hey, thanks for the 19 months of Prime Belly. Afternoon, welcome back. Green black, like company stompy here, looks like. Oh no! Get how rude this is! Oh! I have no idea what Briggy is, or why. You gotta tell me why we should play a card. Never mind. This is a viewer submission. Rather than asking me why not, tell me why we should. Is that lethal? I feel like that's gotta be lethal with the card, right? QQ doesn't tap my creatures for mana. Okay, and then, so I can do this and we can play Tameo, and Tameo's going to pick up the Kinian out of my graveyard. And Kinian's gonna let me not only make, well, I forgot to make mana though, that's fine though. So Kinian doubles up the mana we make. And then I'm gonna get to floop the entirety of my deck into play with Kinny. And look at top 5 cards deck, put a non-human creature from the amount of battlefield, the rest of the bottom of your deck in order. Okay, so. So Kinny would have flooped a bunch of things into play. Would that have actually done? Oh, and then Kinian floops Fae of Wishes into play, and then Fae of Wishes returns to our hand, and then Fae of Wishes gets the win con from our sideboard. Got it. So for people that aren't familiar with how that works, you make all of your mana. Oh yeah, you could also, this picks a, what is it? This picks a permanent up, return a non-land permanent to your hand. Yeah, so you make a bunch of mana, blink Karn with statue, and then you go get the Aetherflux Reservoir from your sideboard. There were a lot of ways to eat that Rhesus chat. I hope everybody understands. Was that clear? Very straightforward, not convoluted. Stale moves. Thanks for the 2 months of Prime. I appreciate that. Welcome back. Good morning. Good morning. I love single player puzzle games. I think we mulligan looking for a piece of Rampier. Yo, low swaggins. All right. We're gonna play this. We're gonna play this Chromatic Sphere. We're gonna draw a second land in our two and our three draws. Nailed it! Never didn't have it. Easy game, easy life. Sphere is ramp with Kinney, and you are correct. That is in fact how our Magic the Gathering works. Can I just do this turn? Oh, I guess she just dies to the Steel Leaf Champion here.
I'm sorry, but I must tend to my creations.
Tap my elf and my Mox cast Tamio.
Let us have a story.
What do we look for here, Emery? Cause I can spell bomb the ooze.
Let me aid your research.
I have one Emery, really? Okay, well, I'm gonna time you out because that's wrong. There are definitely four Emerys in the deck. I was like, that's not true. Well, there's only two pair. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to name a four of with this card, chat. There's only two Paradox Engines. I think it was Emery or Karn were the two different things we could potentially name there. I decided to go with Emery. I would also accept that Karn's probably a reasonable thing to grab. We're attacking me. Yeah, deal. No blocks. I think we named Karn now, since we drew Emery skillfully. The great creator, right? Clearly should have named Emery again. Obs. Should have played the Emery first, chat. Should have played the Emery first. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I can activate this. We can do that on their turn too, right? So we're just passing. Never lucky, Darkius. Is it actually correct line to play Emery first? It's not. Because if I'm going to hit Karn, I want all my mana available. Ooh, that's a good thought. It could be right to play Emery first, because if we hit Karn, we can downtick with it. Well, if that's your thinking, say that that's your thinking. Don't make me guess at what you're thinking. The people in chat that are asking me for suggestions on cards and good lines and plays, it's like, I've literally never played this before. I'm feeling it out just like you. So rather than asking me to justify your suggestion, tell me why your suggestion's good and let's talk about it. Kevin, thanks for the follow. Welcome to the channel. Man, just the most brutal variance today. That's super unfortunate. We just bought him two cards. I'm pretty sure I'm still just naming. I guess I haven't seen a Paradox Engine yet. So there's like two Paradox Engines in the top, whatever. I think we actually named Paradox Engine now. Because there's only one Karn the Great Creator in my top, however many cards.
I think you will find my notes helpful.
Okay, so they're dead, right? The game is over. I have a sphere in here, right? Yeah, I get to draw my deck. Okay, so Chromatic Sphere with Kinian and Paradox Engine here is infinite mana. And we get to draw the entirety of my deck. My opponent's conceding. Yeah, so I have infinite mana. I get to draw my entire deck with Chromatic Sphere, and then we pick one of the six ways we have to actually end the game. What a silly deck. Very, very straightforward, chat. Very, very straightforward. Undefeated. Yeah, this deck is literally KCI. If you're a sociopath who enjoyed playing Crocklon Ironworks in Modern, this is your historic deck. Settle up. Tree Trunks, good morning and welcome to the channel. With a ringing endorsement like that, I found my historic deck. Hey, chat! Yeah! Yeah, nice Mind Stone! Get prisoned! Alright, what are we doing with this? I'm drawing something, I don't know what though. You just like grab Spyglass? I think I just grab Spyglass. Do I want to grab Engine proactively? Yeah, Engine's probably not terrible to grab. Yeah, it's probably right. It's fine. All right, so they have 2 mana available. So I have 6. I'm gonna grab the Spyglass and take a peek at their hand to know if this Tamiyo is safe to resolve. Wow, they just didn't foretell this because they wanted to bluff something. Teferi, Hero of Dominaria. Good night. Okay, we name Kinian with this, right?
I am Tamiyo. It is an honor to meet you. I know I noted this somewhere.
It's Kinian Bonder Prodigy. Oh yeah, bond me, baby. Just like we drew it up. Oh, they're gonna cycle. They're not bluffing, they're cycling the irrigated farmland, sure. Should we keep Spellbound in hand for a cheap untap later? That's a good thought. That's not something I considered, but you might be right. That's nice. Oh, see, so Satolution, your play was kinda correct, but I knew I was gonna draw this Mox Amber, so I decided my play was better. Seats. It wasn't sloppy play. I just knew I was gonna draw what I needed. And to the someone who said we should have named Emry earlier, if I would have named Emry earlier, I would have missed. Whereas I named Kinian earlier, so I hit now. For those of you that are keeping track at home. How dare you insult- like, this is making up for the variance we had earlier, right? We got really unlucky in the last game. Alright, and then we get to do this, and then we get to do this. And then... Are they gonna pack to negation me? Or just reading it, okay. I was like, you definitely don't want to pack to negation me. This does not make mana right now.
There is great power in the things we make.
I'd Pact of Negation because I'd leave quicker. It's a strong line. Alright, they gotta interact with my board or they're dead. Blue-white control and making no plays that impact the board till turn 5. Name a more iconic duo. So... we use the spell bomb to redraw Emery, and then we use Tamio to pick Kinnean back up.
The past is never forgotten.
Oh no! Anyways. I'm not doing anything with mana production this turn.
Allow me to
we're just passing jet. Mine. Oh yeah, if we untap, they're dead. Oh, that's a good call. If I would have been better with the mana, we could have activated Kinnean. That's a good call. I forget this card has text on it. It's a great thing to point out. I appreciate that. I'm pretty sure we just don't sideboard with this deck, right? Like, this negate is here to get with Fae of Wishes on occasion.
Defend my ally. True goodness can never be corrupted.
Well, that That's not a card I realized I was playing around. I guess this kind of makes sense with Gear Hulk. This is one we'll want to think about in future sequencing decisions, though. For sure. Snuggles for days. Thanks for the follow. Someone asked what I was eating this morning. I was eating a Nature Valley packed and sustained energy bar, peanut butter and cranberries. This stream is in no way sponsored or endorsed by Nature Valley, but Nature Valley, if you're out there, it certainly could be. Let's talk. Yeah, I think I have blueberry ones in my bin too. There's definitely cranberry and blueberry. I think the blueberries have almonds instead of peanut butter in them. Yeah, the blueberries are almond butter instead of peanut butter. Oh, this is really cute. Wow, that's gonna let them close really quickly, huh? So they're copying this. They don't get something to. They don't have anything to flash back with it. That's neat. That's a neat amount of closing power in their archetype. Fling, good morning and welcome to the channel. We're dead. Five, six, seven, eight. Yeah. Yeah, seems fine, right? Not amazing, but fine. We get to go Elf into Florahedron Mindstone, or Florahedron's Land Mindstone the following turn. That's a two land hand. Tangle four hedrons of Depthland. Bly, good morning. The timer at the start of the match is just so long. Are they ghosting me? Nah. Listen, chat. My friendo here playing blue-white control at 94% on the ladder is almost assuredly playing Magic for fun. If we were, like, playing in a tournament and there were maybe some kind of meaningful prizes attached, like, maybe, but, like, if that was the case, I would have, if that was the case, I would have a delay up. Morning, Jin. Playing magic for fun, like some kind of goddamn filthy casual. Those of you that are new to the channel, we play casual magic here. We're not a serious tryhard stream. I think I'm naming Hero of Dominaria here. Oh, plus this so he doesn't die to the shark next turn. To the people doing the typical Magic player thing and acting surprised that my opponent's playing blue-white control, that's the appeal to formats like this, chat. Is there's a deep card pool and you can play whatever you would like to play for the most part. It doesn't matter if your deck is good or bad, you just get to play the cards that you enjoy playing. If you want to play blue-white control, play blue-white control. Don't let me or anybody else stop you. Blue-white control is not on a power level where you should play blue-white control because it's good. But if you really enjoy playing blue-white control, knock your socks off, chat. Go for it. There's nothing wrong with playing blue-white control.
My grief fuels.
I'm gonna grab a backup Paradox Engine, because I kind of got to get through this veto here. I'm surprised I see so little. That again shows a fundamental misunderstanding of these formats. There's not a lot of anything, especially on the ladder. The ladder isn't serious competition, chat. The ladder is people hanging out playing Magic for fun. The prizes associated with playing on the ladder are very minimal to non-existent for most people, especially once you're in Mythic, right? Like, if you don't care about top 1200, like, there's nothing to play for. And even if you care about top 1200, it's, like, not that difficult to get to. All right, we've died. Like, even if you screw around for, like, 3 weeks out of the month and you just, like, tighten up and play serious for the last week, it's not difficult to get top 1200 a lot of the time if you're playing good Magic and you're playing good decks. So, like, format. A question that's come up a lot since we started playing Historic is people keep asking, well, Jeff, what do you think of Historic as a format? And Historic isn't a format that I can give you an educated, informed opinion on, because there just isn't information to generate an informed opinion from. So, like, Standard, For standard, I can pull up MTG Melee and look at a ton of tournaments that have been played and get reasonable sample sizes and good metrics and tell you standard's really healthy right now and reasonable. This format, in a tournament setting, might be a shit show, but we don't actually know because... I'm on the draw, I'm gonna keep this. We don't actually know because there's not tournaments to pull information from. So, like, the question shouldn't be, like, do you think the format's good? The question should be, are you enjoying playing it? And if yes, then yeah, don't worry about what's good, bad, or otherwise. Just play decks that you like. Don't tie your enjoyment of a format or a card game to what other people tell you about it. Like, if you're having fun, who cares about the rest of it, the details? Especially in a format like this where the details are super muddled. I mean, even Hoots won't be very meaningful data. Like, Hoots will be a single tournament with a pretty small sample size. Okay, so I'm gonna have a lot of mana. My dead next turn? I don't know if I'm dead next turn. So, we block here, we're taking 2, 4, 6, 8, we're not dead. Can I granted this turn and still not die next turn? I think so. We just get River's Rebuke? It's not even very good, right? Like, none of these seem super useful at the moment. It's probably River's Rebuke just to buy time, right? They have 4-5 mana currently. 6, 10, 12, go to 6. How is Sky Sovereign playing to win? Can you explain? Because I don't see it. I actually probably want this to pick Fae of the Wishes back up with later, right? And then I can actually activate Gideon, right? Just do this now and see what we get. Ooh! Found a piece of candy. So then... do I have enough mana to get Paradox Engine into play next turn? I probably should have counted to see if I needed to play this. Well, I could have attacked, sure. I missed 3 points of damage. Trust me when I tell you that the 3 points of damage doesn't matter. Okay, and then I granted
Yeah, we have them dead, right? We get to draw our deck. I believe we win from here, so we get to grab Paradox Engine. Man, Fae Wishes was super impressive here, huh? I did actually need the mana, so I should have counted last turn, but I drew the land, so it doesn't matter. So again, Chromatic Sphere here with Kinning and Paradox Engine means I draw my entire deck and make infinite mana. So I should have counted, and I should have played the Botanical Sanctum, but then I drew the untapped land for the turn, so it didn't matter. Yeah, I made a mistake there, and I should have counted and got bailed out of it. Yeah, the opponent said they were in chat, so they were turning the stream off so we could play. So they've been watching and they've been listening, and they know that we're gonna get them there. The Ban Angels deck is super real. If I was going to put historic decks back up on the website again, the Ban Angels deck would definitely be among them. There's a link to the Angels deck. You can find it on my YouTube channel. There is a playlist of both standard and historic decks on the front page there. It's fine. Amazing, but fine. What's going on, Boneless? Stop it, Steam Flogger. I'm trying to drive traffic to my YouTube channel. My YouTube channel needs subscribers. Like and subscribe, chat. Subscribing is free on YouTube. Oh, I'm a god damn it. The auto mana. Alright, we missed on the Emery. If I hit on Emery there, I was gonna be really sad. I should have left blue floating though. You forgot, please ring that bell. Sorry, I'm not a very good YouTuber. My YouTube channel doesn't grow almost at all compared to Twitch. Like, my YouTube channel has 25,000 subs and my Twitch is like 70,000 followers. So like, there's like magnitudes different in size. So I don't put a lot of effort into. Oh, I only have one artifact anyways. Yeah, good call, right? The other Moxie Ember died. I knew that. Wow! Way to brutalize my Kinian. At least Cameo survives, glass half full.
Subject is easily agitated. To the library.
Think it's just Emery again. Yikes, no Emery in the top third. No, the bell just means more people are likely to watch your video because I'll get a notification that it went up. My Karning here, Karn doesn't really get anything useful, right? Is the problem. I think we're just cycling this. Just doing a little tire spinning. Yeah, I imagine most people don't ring the bell on my YouTube channel because my YouTube channel uploads an incredible volume of content compared to most YouTube channels. Like I post 4 to 5 videos a day when I'm live because of all the different decks that we play. Yeah, we're pretty dead here. Not gonna be able to come back at this point. The interaction on their on our Kinian was rude. Definitely key there. I guess we didn't find much else. We probably would have been dead even without that. Sideboarding with this deck is super easy. Thanks for the follow, Saucy Noodles. Good morning to you. Yeah, this deck that we're playing is like perfectly fine in terms of power level. It's super intractable. This deck cares about lots of different avenues of interaction. In terms of from a pure power level perspective, this deck is more than fine. You can interact with the graveyard, you can interact with creatures, you can interact with their planeswalkers, you can interact with Paradox Engine, like... A lot of different ways that you can stop them from comboing you. Hey, Arpi, thanks for the 14 months. I appreciate that. Welcome back. Was gonna play Tamio to look for Kinnean, but then we drew it. Awesome, Braveheart. Yeah, whenever I bring up that I build and like tune my sideboards in that way, there's always someone that's like, oh, that makes so much sense. And it's just like, oh, this like, it's one of the things I've just like always done. Yeah, Cage, Leyline, Scavenging Ooze. Like, I assume we're not wiggling out here. I guess I can play and plus looking for an Aether Spell Bomb and maybe go next turn. Is that the play? I think that's the play.
Make an excellent informant for my study. I think you will find my notes helpful.
They have an Elvish Archdruid here for their Scavenging Ooze, so... Gonna be up a creek without a paddle here, I think. This one's not gonna last much longer. Yeah, our deck seems very soft, too. Like, playing this deck a little bit more, like, the combo's kind of neat and novel, but the more I'm playing it, the more I see why it's not a particularly, like, popular deck. It's a deck that, like, people that like this style of deck can play, but it doesn't seem particularly strong or busted. Yeah, good games, Tim. Ooh, Brass Monkey in 20th Hoaglandian to achieve Shillionaire status. Can you feel the trickle down, chat? Do you feel that economy working for you? How much easier it is for you at home to pull on your bootstraps and achieve Shillionaire status yourself? The next Shillionaire will now only have to spend 999,980 shillings. It's so achievable. Now I can waste channel point. God bless, Brass. Thanks for watching a bunch. It's good to have you here. Speaking of someone only halfway there, I can feel the capitalism. Yeah, good games, Tim. Only 650,000 points to go. Slow and steady. Slow and steady, Beard Hug. Alright, so... I'm gonna do this and then play a Spell Bomb here. That's true. Unfortunately, YouTube does not contribute to advance of channel points. If you're someone that can't watch me while you work, you just gotta leave a computer on at your house and just always have my channel page up. So, unfortunately, you can't make someone both a VIP and a moderator at the same time. So I can't just give out VIP status because they override each other. But you get a tag in the subs Discord server, and you get access to Beverly Shills in the subs Discord server, and it's where you want to be. Just shilling in the Beverly Hills. Alright, am I just passing? We could Karn and Downtick. We're just passing. I could cycle this to play the Karn, though, if we played, like, the untapped land. This would be 2 and 2. My opponent's got walls, chat. Think they expect the Rakdos to pay for their walls? You don't even have to be a shillionaire to enjoy the subs Discord. This my member list says we currently have 827 people in the Hoaglandia Discord server, and I currently have 2,003 subscribers. That means there's like 1,200 people that aren't living their best life by joining the subs Discord. Live your best life, chat. Come hang out with us. Cricket! Thank you for the 26 months. I appreciate that. Welcome back. All right, well, maybe I'm supposed to bounce one of these here instead of taking the hit. Mox Amber is an absurd draw. Oh, I missed 2 mana. Shit. Is Karn for Ancestral Statue lethal?
Offensive.
How is that lethal? Could someone explain? Oh, cause we get the what's it called? Got it. We end by bouncing. We generate arbitrary amounts of storm. We end by bouncing Karn. We play Karn. We get the. Got it. Okay. I promise you this is necessary, chat. I need to get. Is anybody counting? I need somebody to be counting. I need a storm counter. Chat, you're my storm counter. Am I at 50 yet? Hold on, I'll just check the game log. One moment. I have 25 minutes. I'm gonna do this for 3 minutes. This is more difficult than Dark Souls. Oh, I have Spell Bomb. Is that true? I do have the Spell Bomb. Okay, yeah, good call. Okay, so I'll do this. All right, we're generating storm count, chat. For people that aren't keeping up, we're generating storm count.
Evil must not be conquered. I will rid you of your corruption.
So, I gain a life for every spell I've cast in the turn when I cast with Aetherflux Reservoir.
Fire the laser! Fire the laser!
Hold, hold, please.
It's a chance they're not conceding. I'm gonna kill their board.
Rude, my opponent can concede at any point, as they just demonstrated.
Listen, this is not sadistic. I have a very clear-cut path to victory. I am limited only by the animation speeds on Magic Arena. Okay? It's not my fault. Magic Arena's holding me back with its animation speeds.
I mean, so Kisa's combo is very different than this. So the Kisa's combo deck, I get that they're both Mox Amber decks, but like the Kisa's combo deck wasn't a deterministic combo. Kisa's combo was something that did a sufficiently large amount, generally speaking, but it didn't just loop endlessly like this does in several different ways.
So from like a fundamental perspective, they're very different. Oh, BT Dubs, there's still spots. I should check if there's still spots.
It's almost full. So on March 6th, I am playing in a standard Magic Arena tournament that has $2,000 in prizes plus some Ultimate Guard stuff as a sponsored thing. And it's free to enter, but they're capping at 128 players. And there's a link to the event on MTG Melee. So if you want to sign up to play in it, it's a free 2K tournament that you play from your house on Magic Arena. Looks like there's about 20 spots left. There's 900 of you at home right now, so I imagine you're going to go fill that up.
What's the one gone? Aetherflux Reservoir.
Yeah, I'm interested to see how their thing goes, because like, as someone who's run free entry tournaments before, like, people tend to not show up day of, which is awk. I think I actually want to get Emery down here.
Actually, I can Mind Stone in the Nemer, right? That's how that math works. Yeah.
Math. The more you know.
All of our lovely sponsors on the two different spinners at various points on the screen. Shuffler confirmed. It's also linked down below. We got Stuff Inc., BCW, and Inked Gaming on my Hooglandia one, and then the F2K one's got a few different people that are be rotating in and out at different points. I think we're just passing, right?
Just trying to attack with zero force chat. We're over here being the bad guy.
I'm the bad man.
Duh. Alright, so... we pick up this here Aether Spell Bomb. We can send this Arcanus back from whence it came. Looking for a Kinney in here, I think.
I know I noted this somewhere.
Get some Bonderon. I think I'm holding this for now to pair with Paradox Engine potentially. They could have an enchantment here, like a high alert to let them kill us. They could have a protection spell for Arcanus. Something like dive down. I have to wait till they get to combat, though, to send this back. Indestructible's not gonna do it. You get to draw, though. Oh, you know what? I should have bounced in response to this draw, because they scryed top. They could have drawn the protection spell. They didn't have white mana left. Nice, nice! Your walls have attacked.
Seek and find.
Can I get some bondage? Rats. No, no bondage today, chat. No bondage today. The opponent get auto tapper. No, they played a tap temple, and they played a white spell.
Together, we'll create great things, you and I.
Make some token blockers here. What's going on, Recon Bravo? I'm still here doing the thing. Good morning to you. Lovely wife.
Hi, honey.
How is the day with the monsters? I mean, the children going. You need my phone? It's
upstairs?
I think it's upstairs. Yeah, it's plugged in on the counter.
Came down the stairs for nothing.
Did you find an Articuno raid?
No, nobody will send me an Articuno raid.
Shit! If you play Pokemon Go, my wife desperately needs an Articuno raid.
I mean, you need it too.
My wife desperately needs an Articuno raid. Please, please send help. Also, speaking of the subs Discord, if you're a sub who plays Pokemon Go, we have a very active remote raiding community in the subs Discord. They're lovely. Drop on in sometimes. It's only a Mewtwo. She wasn't giving me a hug, chat. She was reaching into my pocket to see if my cell phone was in it.
In the gutter.
No, not at all. I thought that I didn't want them to think you loved me.
Oh. We're gonna do a Mewtwo raid.
Oh, we're gonna do a Mewtwo raid. Okay, I think I'm cycling the Mind Stone here at end of turn.
We're going for the shiny.
Draw one of these. Honestly, it's probably right to cycle the spell bomb too at this point, right? Because it's not working with this anymore. I have lethal in the yard. Because of the paradox engine, the Kinney makes it really easy. I believe you that I had it without Kinnean, but Kinnean helps.
I follow the tracks of the wise.
I actually don't even think Ugin's very good in standard, John Charlie. Like, I know it harshes some people's mellow, but like, when you look at the decks that are good in the format, Ugin, like, doesn't make the cut at all. And again, for reference, for people that are just joining us and haven't seen us playing this monstrosity, at this point, I have unlimited mana, and I have unlimited card draw, and we're gonna pick up the entirety of our deck here. I'm being super sloppy with how I'm tapping things, cause why not, but. Yeah, we have unlimited servos too, technically. Oh, and I have Fae of Wishes, right? So I can go get the thing. Prepare the beam cannon! Technically, I missed floating mana there, I'm aware. I'm aware I technically missed floating mana, okay? It doesn't matter. As it doesn't even matter which artifact I click on. Should we kill their board? Does chat want to kill their board? I feel like I've met chat before and chat wants to kill their board. I mean, to be fair, it becomes very easy to kill their board pretty quickly here. We're soon going to be gaining like 25 per thing here. How am I tapping non-land mana so quickly? QQ. If you double tap the Q key on your keyboard, it taps all of your non-creature resources for mana. So QQ, I'm just not floating with Land War Elf because it doesn't matter. Should we copy Aetherflux? Oh, because copy artifacts? Target artifacts you control because copy another target artifact or creature you control. Oh, yeah!
I like to think fast.
Oh, yeah, that's the... I forgot Saheeli could do that shit. She does so much. Hey, Osted, thank you for the 29 months. I appreciate that. Welcome back. Why are we being mean? No, I'm just doing things. Okay, listen. Listen. I signed up for this ladder match the same as my opponent. They don't want to play, they may concede, okay? It's not mean, that's just how the game works. Alright, I think I've held enough people hostage from there. I think I've seen what I need to see, and I've put enough extra clicks on my mouse to put extra clicks on my mouse. People that aren't new to the stream know that, like, when there's a deck that's like an established archetype like this, I try to shy away from giving anything too terribly strong in terms of opinions on it. This deck's linear game plan seems fine. At a glance, and this could definitely part of this is my inexperience with the deck playing against interaction, but this deck definitely didn't feel amazing against interaction. Like, you care about creature removal, you care about people attacking your planeswalkers, graveyard hate is good, discard spells and counter spells are good, so like, you can interact with this deck on almost every possible axis of interaction that exists in Magic. So I think if you're like into KCI style decks, I'm sure there's a ton of things to optimize and tweak and tune to your heart's desire in a deck like this. Like, I'm sure someone who's played this deck could tell me 800 different things in chat that they could do slightly differently, but I don't really have strong opinions on any of them after playing this for 90 minutes or so. Thanks for the 22 months, Meta Magic Missile. Welcome back. Yeah, let's play some Tempered Steel. I feel bad. Tempered Steel got like...